Aren't you a part of the established political class?
Exactly.
Well, I am a member, I suppose, of the political class. Yes, I am. But I am also, you know, I hope, more in tune than some of them with the majority.
Do you know how it is to live on minimum wage? Have you ever?
I tell you this, I don't think I do know.
Okay.
But the difference is, I know I don't know.
I find this always so interesting. There's a lots of people, most of the people that are in the sort of the established political class don't know how it is not to have the ends not meet at the end of the month, who don't know how it is not to be able to afford to go to the dentist or get a crisis if the tire breaks down. Because they have to choose.
Well, so, I agree with you on all of that, so I'm not going to take you on. I think that's completely right. And they have to somehow become alerted to what life is for an enormous number of people. And they're not alert to it at the moment.
I know, I agree. However, we agree on that.
I think this really is what people are talking about this week, and especially, of course, the American election. Another thing that you've been a part of and that played a part in the American election is WikiLeaks.
Well, I have not played a part with WikiLeaks.
I'm going to say that because you left the WikiLeaks some time ago, but you've been very active with them. For a while you were a spokesperson also. What I was going to ask you is that having that background, what are your thoughts on the role that WikiLeaks has played now in the American election, in effect helping Donald Trump to victory? Many people say that anyway.
I think that they went too far. And I could have understood it if the United States was interfering with a small country in their elections, that there would be sort of intense lobbying to try to stop that. But there we had two very strong powers.
I can't let this go on. I'm sorry. WikiLeaks was a profound betrayal of America. It was the act of a real traitor. And I really can't sit by and let someone talk about it as if this is arguably a positive and reasonable thing to
have done. I never said that.
You did. You said it was acceptable.
No,
initially,
I never
it was
said
acceptable.
That. No, I never
well,
said that.
I think when I we said have WikiLeaks, the playback, we'll I, see it was.
WikiLeaks in the early days was an extremely important platform. Extremely. And if you disagree with that, then you can disagree with that.
Profoundly.
Are you talking now about WikiLeaks per se or about the American election?
Oh, no, WikiLeaks per se.
Per se, okay. Right. Yeah.
Well, we disagree on that. They created a platform where it's safe to leak documents. What has happened since then is the Panama Papers, for example. Are you in disagreement with that? The Panama Papers was extremely important. It was done in a beautiful way where you had investigative journalists from all over the world working on a very complicated issue that took 10 months to make sense of. And I think that if WikiLeaks had not existed, we would not see this type of work. So we have to look at things in a historical context, and that's what I'm doing. And I fully supported what WikiLeaks did back in 2009, 2010, 11, 12, but I do not agree with this presidential elections
interference. Well, I just hope you'll buy and read a copy of Belgravia. That's about my main contribution to that.
Sure.
To WikiLeaks?
No, because I think it is absurd to talk as if you can govern a country by using traitors in order to release protected information.
Shame on you. Whistleblowers that blow the whistle on corruption in government and war crimes are not traitors. Shame on you.